Here's an interesting thing too, I think. Reciprocating motion is not useful motion. You can't use it. So, a perfect example of reciprocating motion.
You're gonna have to get out of here.
And the beat goes on. So, but rotary motion is useful motion.
Right.
But in this, to operate that igniter, they had to go from rotary motion back to reciprocating motion to make it operate.
Okay.
So you see how they did it? See that tip? They're running on the face of that gear.
I do
gear.
See that, and I was wondering what that's all about.
That's called a cam on the face of that
right.
gear.
It's coming in and out.
Right. But that gives you this motion.
Okay. So that's
so you see how they had to go from rotary motion back to reciprocating motion. To get the feature that they needed. This is the igniter. This is where the spark is coming from.
Oh, I see.
Yeah, this is the intake valve. The exhaust valve.
Okay.
This is today we call it carburetor, but they call it a mixture.
Mixture.
In here.
Right. That's your igniter.
This is before spark plugs. So the points come together. It completes the circuit. It's when they come open.
That's your spark.
It draws the spark.
Okay.
Whereas with a spark plug, they had to go to a high tension coil to boost the voltage even further, because now you want that voltage to jump a gap.
Right.
Kind of the opposite. This is the opposite. This is almost like an induced spark, whereas a spark plug is a forced spark.
Yeah.